place that belonged to all at that time? And why is it now that nobody wants the center except those who are benefiting from the center? We have to understand that we have experienced a somersault of our federation before our own eyes. And it is because we have not addressed the fact that it is the problem that the Northwest has created in the center, fostered by the military when they were in power. And I go back to, just a second, I go back to the question of oil. You know that in 1959, there was this Raymond Commission that said that, okay, let us give them 50% of oil because of mineral resources. Everybody should take care of the mineral resources because oil at that time had not become dominant. Immediately, oil became dominant and the military oligarchy took over. It became 1.5% up to the time of Shagari.
Okay, I need to stop you there. Professor Odika, let me come back to you. He's talking there about a narrative that puts the problem squarely on a particular region, the Northwest, he said, and the problem that they've caused, and the lack of attraction, he says, for the center, for everybody except them, is what he seems to imply. Is that narrative accurate in your view? And will it allow us to arrive? Because, you know, if you don't analyze it well, people will say you can't get to the right solution. Does that ring true?
You know, I still come back to this issue of a single identity narrative. Northwest. Northwest is another way of saying Fulani. In the Nigerian epithets of these things, yes? And the fact of the matter is, God bless his soul, Thomas Aninkanu was buried yesterday. He has more in common with the Boy Is Good, Mbazilika Amechi, in Enugu, than he has with the Almajiri in Kano. And so we create these identity boxes. The reality is that I've got more in common with Mohamed Kumalia than he has with the Almajiri in Maiduguri, or that I have with the IPOB advocate in Aba. Reality. So let the way Nigeria is, we are misaligned in between our reality and the way we communicate our identities. And for me, I hear all the talk about restructuring, but the biggest issue in my life, my own biggest agenda, is an end to militarism. Because the reason we are all complaining about structure is that none of us had a part in creating the structure we had here. Mm-hmm. The biggest agent, so the agency issue is the biggest issue for me. The biggest agent in this structure is the military. President Buhari is a military man. He's not a civilian, I'm not mistaken about that. Mm-hmm. Obasanjo, military. The first thing we have got to do is take paternalism of military rule out of Nigeria. Let citizens get together and fix our country.
How? In practical terms. What do we
don't
need to
vote
do?
For any more soldier in our country. Very simple. We will not vote for any other soldier, no matter how the person is marketed. Let citizens trust one another. That, for me, is the first thing.
Okay, but if, for example, you're a young man sitting in, Aba,
yes,
and you're not working, and you're feeling disenfranchised, and you're tired, and you're saying, Biafra represents hope for me, and maybe within that particular geographical entity, I might become something. If you tell me when 2019 comes, do not vote for a military man, vote for a civilian, and that's the end of your problem, I may not be convinced.
No, you don't have to be. Now, what is the issue?
So the question I'm asking is, because there are real issues.
Why are people disengaged from Nigeria?
That are confronting, everyday Nigerians is the issue I'm asking. So Mr. Kumalia made a reference to the fact that, a Nigeria, for example, that provides practical things like healthcare, employment, security, because, all over the country there are theaters of conflict. So in practical terms, how do we begin to address these problems while also putting together a structure that provides political stability and economic prosperity for the majority of our people?
Why is it that we've got the army deployed in 28 states out of 36?
That's the question.
Why is it the Nigerian police force doesn't work? Under whom was the police force destroyed? Now, when you look at the details of where we are, it comes down to militarism. The fact that everybody, that the leadership, and that's why, you know, Nigerians talk to one another with immediate effect. And right now, the way we discuss one another, the aggression, the ordering of our neural wiring is very military. And we've got to end it. That, for me, is the biggest thing. Different people will disagree. But the reality is that the reason Nigeria is stuck in the rut that it is because the military has rewired our country. If we don't end it, we are not going to make any progress with restructuring.
Okay, I have very little time before the program is ending, and I'd want to come back to the panel. So I'd like to take a few more people in the audience very quickly, a minute each. The lady, then the gentleman in the purple tie, then the gentleman in black. Where is the microphone, please? And then we'll come back to the, yeah, so about four people, five, and then quickly, maybe a minute and a half each, please, because time is gone, yeah?
Okay. My name is Rose Benokabwe. I'm from Anambra State, and I'm a management consultant. We've talked a lot about restructuring, and one thing that keeps coming up is bad leadership, and the truth is the two are related. And you cannot solve one without the other. Restructuring is all well and good. Like somebody said, we've been restructuring forever. And we can continue restructuring from now till thy kingdom come if we do not solve the real problem, which is bad leadership. Restructuring will not help the country. It will never help the country.
And so in a sentence, how do we solve the leadership problem?
How do we do that? We have to change the way the leaders emerge. We have to start from the beginning and change the way we get these leaders. And it's not just military, because some of them are not military, but they're just ignorant.
Okay, so party
yes.
Politics. And
so we need to educate the public. We need to actually educate the public. When somebody comes to you and gives you a bag of rice, that does not make the person a good leader. When somebody has led you for 4 years and done absolutely nothing, and at the end of that 4 years they give you a bag of rice, that person is not a good leader, and you will suffer for the next 4 years.
So if you don't have rice at home and your children are dying of hunger,
take the rice, but don't vote for them.
Okay, let's move to the next person, please. Yes, sir, to tell us who we are quickly.
Good evening. My name is Chata Wanza. I work with SBM Intelligence. I have a question for all four panelists, and it's as a result of this. We all agree that there's a need for some restructuring, but we have short-term problems, medium-term problems, and long-term problems. Please, all of you, in your words, because when I see 20,000 people outside Nnamdi Kanu's house, it's a cry for help I see. When I see thousands of youths milling around doing nothing on Niger Road in Kanu, it's a cry for help. So how will you solve in the short term this big problem of unemployment for youth, which is fueling all of the security problems in the country and giving people, giving unsavory characters a voice?
Okay, and you will answer it as you're rounding up. So, yeah, hold on to that question in your mind. Yes, the gentleman in the purple tie.
My name is Stanley Bentu. I'm a radio presenter, and by nature of my job is to listen to people. So I listen to and get responses from them. And one of the things that I've observed that I think that is a little bit lacking in a lot of our conversations is the how to address fear, because that is what I hear and perceive. There's fear of domination. If you listen to conversations across board, this fear comes across. So we talk about restructuring very often, but the challenge is that whenever I'm with a guest and I ask them a question, how do we do this? The answer is always, we need it, we need it, we need it. But when you come to the laws and principles of conflict resolution, you will not achieve anything simply because you need it. You achieve it because you have addressed the fears of your adversary.
Okay, then I'm going to have told you that there's a gentleman in white in the middle here. Microphone, please. I literally have 2 minutes to come back to the panel and close this show, so we have to hurry. Okay.
My name is Abdulrazak Velu Barkindo. I'm the spokesman for the Nigerian Governors Forum, and I hope nobody says, aha, here they come. I'm very happy that everybody here agrees that Nigeria